When it comes to car crash safety tests, the federal government treats males and females differently.
They typically have a male dummy in the driver's seat and then that female in a passenger or in the back seat.
Our investigation uncovered in most car crash safety tests, a female is not used in the driver's seat. So experts say those often advertised five-star ratings for safety aren't accurate for women, who are statistically more likely to be severely injured or die from a crash.
There should not be a difference on your gender. When you look at the rating, it should be equal for everybody. And I think it's misleading when it doesn't offer you the same equivalent rating.
This is an administration touting itself on equity.
Yes.
You would think this administration would want to make these changes, right?
I think absolutely.
But when our White House correspondent John Decker brought our findings to the Biden administration, they sidestepped giving an opinion.
Since our investigation, bipartisan legislation has been introduced in both the House and the Senate to correct this gender inequity. I was hoping that you could weigh in on this issue, number one, and could you support that type of legislation?
Well, I do know that NHTSA, who oversees this effort, does use female crash test dummies in some of their safety testing and uses data to determine where to use which sized and gendered dummies. They also use computer simulation, in addition, to enhance their research and fund the Global Human Body Model Consortium, which has developed simulation models for a variety of occupants, including men and women, but also children, the elderly, and more. So that's another way they rely on data. But otherwise, I would refer you to NHTSA, who would have more additional information. I don't have any announcements about support for legislation at this point in time.
White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki couldn't say if the administration supported bipartisan legislation to force automakers to test females. In her answer, Psaki referenced NHTSA does require some female dummies to be tested in the driver's seat, which is true. What she didn't say, only in one type of test, when a driver hits a fixed object at a 75-degree angle. Those tests use a petite female dummy, 4'11", 108 pounds. The facts show right now front and side impact collision tests don't include female dummies. Statistics show around 80% of all passenger vehicle deaths involve these types of impact.
There should be movement to put a change in place yesterday.
Remember, the White House referred us to the federal agency NHTSA.
I would refer you to NHTSA.
In the past, NHTSA had declined our request for an interview. But when we reached out to NHTSA again following this press briefing, this time the agency never responded.
Are you surprised if I tell you that NHTSA, when I reached out to them, declined to do an on-camera television interview?
Well, you know, it's unacceptable. They need to face this issue and help us get it done and make it more equitable for women.
While the Biden administration and NHTSA stay relatively silent on the issue, a bipartisan group of lawmakers have written three bills. They're hopeful by the end of this year, they'll provide the president with legislation that will force the government to change policies that for decades have led to a collision division on our roadways.